Good morning, everybody. It's Glenn with the Cactus Atlas, about to take you on a quick hike through Red Rock Canyon State Park in the beautiful state of California. Let's get to it. So today we're going to be hiking maybe one of the more popular trails here called the Hagen Canyon Nature Trail. And you can see behind here, it's known for its really beautiful rusty red cliffs and some of those really awesome grays. Right off the bat, it's already very pretty. And here's a very brief introduction to Red Rock Canyon State Park. And maybe more importantly for you guys, that's the little loop trail we're going to be doing today. I've read that it's about a little over a mile long, so we're supposed to see some really cool formations here too. Alrighty, let's start this trail. It's already a little toasty out here. Probably not the most ideal lighting conditions. It's about 9:30 right now in the morning. I had to drive over here from Kernville, spent the night there, and yesterday I saw the Trail of 100 Giants. That was so amazing, and I thought I'd just stop here. I've always wanted to visit this place, and it happened to be on the way to my next destination.
Red Rock Canyon, located in the El Paso Mountains of California, has been a natural pass for generations, attracting Native Americans and wagon caravans to local springs and its natural beauty. Even further back in history, evidence of prehistoric animals such as mammoths, bison, and mastodons have been found in the area. The Kawaiisu tribe referred to the land as the canyon with rocks on fire. A German immigrant by the name of Rudolph Hagen moved into the canyon in 1895. Hagen quickly set out mining claims and water rights to gold mining operations in the area and established a community named Ricardo after his son. Hagen acquired much of the land and created a map of the area, naming many of the unique features he found. As the route through the El Paso Mountains from Bishop to Los Angeles became paved and tourism out west expanded, many found interest in the landscape of Red Rock Canyon and used the maps that Hagen created for exploration. Eventually, by 1969, the Hagen family turned over the land to become part of the state park system in order to preserve the land and prevent further damage. Today, the park offers plentiful hiking, camping, and views of spectacular rock formations.
I'm pretty sure you're permitted to go up there and explore and take a closer look, which we will be doing. I have not seen any signs that say one should not do that, and I've seen other folks exploring in other videos. So I would think it's okay. In fact, what do you say we go take a quick peek up there? The geology here is wonderful. The coloration, the shapes. Some of this looks a little reminiscent of Bryce Canyon. That might be a little bit of a stretch, but fantastic. That is really cool. So this all formed from sediments. This used to be under a lake long time ago. I didn't get the exact number of years ago, but I'm sure it was a long time ago. But yeah, this stuff just formed. I believe it's just various sediments condensed down. You can really see some cool layering up there too. What do you say we continue down the trail and seek out some cooler formations? It is rather toasty today. You know, for 9:30 in the morning, it's already in the 90s out here. A little bit of a breeze to help out, but obviously this is exposed as you get to the sun. It's hot already. I imagine as the day goes on, it might not be too comfortable to continue, but we should be done as this is only about a mile long, I believe. Well, there's a few little Joshua trees hanging out over here too. I drove through lots of Joshua tree forests, some conserved areas on the way here, so I'm not too surprised to see that. I imagine the colors would be much more vibrant here if it was earlier in the morning or much later in the day. Something to think about. They have a campground here, there's more canyons to explore, I believe, so this is definitely worth coming back. We'll call this our initial scouting mission. How about that? And there's a lone Joshua tree hanging out before this amazing landscape. Look at that. I'll give you a close-up look here. These things have these weird, almost like palm tree, like those fern palms, or fan palms, rather. And they all have these nubs of very spiky and sharp, I don't know what you would call those. I doubt they're called leaves, but whatever that is, they're hard. It's like wood. Probably would poke your finger real good on that if you're not careful. Nice, the trail is heading straight towards these red cliffs to give us a better look. Wow, these colors are fantastic. I love that gray mixed in with a red. Really neat. Really pretty. I think, is this not the rocked up camel rock that we saw on the sign there? It kind of looks like one. I think that's one of the ones that Mr. Hagen named. And is this the little window rock? Oh yeah, look at that. That's pretty neat. Well, there's only one thing that one should do about that, huh? Wow, this is cool. Standing on top of what I think is the camel, and yeah, this stuff is really cool. It almost, in a weird way, looks like something you might see in a cave, although this isn't formed from a cave. Like all of those weird formations and shapes. Yeah, this is really cool. You definitely want to climb up a little bit to get better views, for sure, such as. That's the best part, I think, about this, is just climbing and exploring the rocks. I'd say that's better than the trail. You really need to get up closer to this stuff to explore it really well. There's lots of little shady places like this to hide out from the sun. It's quite nice. Drink some cool water, let the cameras cool down. Nice. Now, I think this may have been the end of the trail, actually. You can see the trail right down there. Let's go take a peek and see if it keeps going or not. I mean, there's more red rocks over there. Sure, if I just wanted to walk over there, I could. Apparently, there have been a lot of films made here There was a really long list that I found online, and of course I can't remember a single one of them right now. But I'm not saying, I don't know if this exact area is where they filmed. I think in Red Rock Canyon State Park they have probably this with a backdrop. This is very picturesque, movie worthy. All right, let's make one more push. Let's try to go over here and let's see if we can kind of make our way up there. I'm not sure about that yet, but I'm gonna give it a try. I mean, I know if I go back up that way, I can. I would say at the very least, you know, I've seen a lot of people do this. They'll just kind of go off the main road out there, pull in, walk out here, get a few pictures and leave. And that's totally cool. This is a very picture-worthy spot. So be sure to stop. I mean, this trailhead is right off the main route. I mean, right when you get in, can't miss it. Let's get right up tight on this here. Watch out for snakes, of course. Doubt we'll see anything, but you never know. Oh, this is cool. You can get right up there. It is awesome up there. I explored up there a little bit, but I don't want to bring my camera up there. Even right here, that loose dirt, I came close to falling a couple times. I'm not going to chance it with this camera. Not today. All right, let's head back down here. This is awesome. Okay, I'm heading back. Holy moly, it's hot. And besides, I think we hit the end of the trail, if I'm not mistaken. I left a lot unexplored, to be honest. This is a really quick introduction to this place. I could walk all the way back there if I wanted to, and you'd probably get better photos there, but I'm throwing in the towel. All right, so Red Rock Canyon State Park. There's much more to do here, by the way, than just this. I haven't even scratched the surface. Not even on this trail, I think there's more to do. I'll be back in a future date and we'll do a much more thorough exploration of this after I educate myself. But this was fantastic. I loved it. And if you've never heard of it, I hope I put it on the map for you.